Today, we're going to be breaking down the Defiance of Yasmin and the Black Spindle. They are both top-tier PvE snipers and are able to dish out more damage than pretty much any gun in the game. The reason why is because of the mechanics that they have built into their perks and the way you can use these guns to optimize your damage in a short amount of time. So let's get into it. So this raid sniper has a perk called Perfectionist, where if you get kills with every shot in your magazine, you're going to get all your ammo back. This is great for conserving special ammo. It does feel very nice when you get it, but for the most part, it's pretty hard to use. Now, in the next tree here, we don't have a lot to choose from that's really going to help you. The stability can definitely help from injection mold, but for the most part, I feel that Lightweight's agility is a nice boost. The big perk on this gun though is Cocoon. So after you've fired your gun, you can put it away, use your primary, use your heavy, and when you come back to it, it's going to be reloaded. There's about a 10 second cooldown on it, but it is huge and allows you to do some DPS stuff that is insane. As for the muzzles, it's not going to change a whole bunch in your stats, just the recoil pattern, so I stick with Linear Compensator because that seems to work for me. So let's look at this gun, look at the damage, and what it can really do. So the big thing, as I said before, is the Cocoon perk. I can do a bunch of damage, and then go to my primary, do as much damage as I can here, reload, and then I'm back to my sniper. So this saves 2 or 3 seconds every single reload with the gun. And over the course of an engagement, I'm saving 15, 20, 25 seconds of downtime when I could have been doing damage. This is huge, especially in something like a raid, because when there are small moments like this where you're actually able to do damage, you're now optimizing the time you are doing that damage. I recognize you have to switch to your primary, but in cases where you only have a 30 second window to do damage like Atheon, you're going to double or triple the damage of the people around you, simply because you aren't reloading. It's a very, very nice perk, one of the best, and the reason why we're comparing the Defiance of Yasmin to Black Spindle is because Black Spindle is literally the only gun in the game currently that can compete with this sniper for damage. I'll show you why in a second. Black Spindle does work a lot differently than the Defiance of Yasmin. It has Mulligan in case you miss a shot, Snapshot if you want to aim a little bit quicker, Flared Magwell, which is a wasted perk on this, and Perfect Balance if you want to be a little bit more stable, less recoil. But the big perk on this is the White Nail perk. So if you rapidly hit 3 headshots or crits, you're actually going to get all your ammo back from your reserves. It's got some decent scopes, it's got some closer range scopes than the Defiance of Yasmin, so you can actually use this gun a little bit more close quarters and not feel so disoriented than the long range zoom of the Defiance of Yasmin. If you want some longer range zoom though, you can get that. So let's see how the White Nail perk works. So if you've ever used a Black Hammer, this is going to feel very similar. The only difference is now, when you are landing your crits, the ammo doesn't come out of thin air, it does come out of your reserves. So you're gonna pound through ammo very quickly, but that's okay, because you never have any time where you're reloading, this gun is going to do a bunch of damage. If you can land every single shot, your entire reserve ammo is used up, no gun will beat the Black Spindle. It is simply the highest DPS you can get from a sniper. However, if you miss a shot, you have now ruined the opportunity for the White Nail perk to proc, and you have to reload your gun. So it adds reload speed into this, and it becomes a situation where it isn't necessarily better. The Defiance of Yasmin, you can pump out your shots, and if you happen to hit a rock or the enemy keeps jumping around, you still don't have to deal with reloading, ever. And this really does boost your DPS, so if there is an enemy that's jumping around all the time, you're gonna have issues with the Black Hammer being as efficient as the Defiance of Yasmin. Being the PvP guy I am, I wanted to test these out, take them into the Crucible, and see how they felt. Not that they're terrible guns, but I didn't have as much luck with them as I do with other snipers. I've got, what, 30, 40,000 sniper kills, and I really did feel that this gun, unfortunately, wasn't the best. Black Spindle felt very, very heavy, sluggish. The fire rate on it is awful, and it's only got 3 shots in the magazine. It does have great impact, and you can pump people who are in their super, kill them in one shot, something like this. But for the most part, I don't feel any benefit when using the Black Spindle. It just doesn't bring enough to the table, unfortunately. I felt sluggish. Target acquisition wasn't the best, it doesn't have massive aim assist on it, and I tried a couple different scopes. Ambush was definitely my favorite because I like closer range scopes, but I still felt very handicapped when using this gun. I wouldn't really recommend it. As for the Defiance of Yasmin, it's a long range scope default, you can't change it, and I actually had more luck with it, oddly enough, even though I don't like long range scopes, but maybe it was just the game type or the maps I was on, I did have quite a bit of luck with this gun, but I don't think it was necessarily aim assist or anything like that, just good positioning, and I got lucky with where people were going on the map. This again doesn't have very good perks, and other than the reloading thing, I wouldn't really use this in PvP either. There's going to be better guns out there, and you're going to find some random blue gun or a random legendary that drops from the Crypt Arc or a package, and you're going to have a lot better luck with something like that. You can hopefully cater it to your PvP setup and make a gun that's definitely more suited for the Crucible. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and it all made sense. I'd love to hear your thoughts on these guns in the comments below. Thanks Planet Destiny for having me, thanks for watching, and if you'd like to see more stuff from me, my channel is MTashed, where I focus a lot on PvP, but also some guides on things like the raid. Have a great one everyone, bye bye!